Hi guys, thank you all for watching an episode of the How to DYLC Fire Eagle Radio Tours 12-48 upgrade and mod series, where today's episode we are going to upgrade to a completely full metal servo with only 3 wires instead of the strange 5 wire servos that are just horrible and more expensive to replace. And it's not my best servo, it's my worst servo, but I have a full metal servo. It's a TowerPro MG91. It has 2.5 kilos of torque, very similar to the stock servo, but of course it got 3 wires, that's what we need. And by luck, the servo saver fits exactly on top. It's a very snug fit, and I have to use my hammer, or maybe heat up the plastic and then push it over. It's a really nice snug fit. So that's perfect, so I can keep using the servo saver, and now we only have to sand the plastic and make it a little bit rough. The same thing for the servo, and then use some 2-component epoxy to glue it in place and lock it in. Let's get to it and make sure we get a nice snug fit and make sure that the servo is centered up. Our first step is actually removing the pinball. That's going to be our connecting to the steering rod, of course. And we're going to place it one position higher to get more steering angle. Plus, I want to have a flat surface when I'm gonna use the hammer to give it a few taps. A lot of taps to get it onto the servo. And I hope it doesn't break. Be a good bone. And of course, you add a screw. Make sure 100% sure it's gonna stick in its place. Tie that up. I'm trying the screw to make it sure it goes a little bit more onto it, but it looks like a good job. And of course, add the ball joint at the highest position so we get the maximum angle. The next step is make a 2-component epoxy, of course, and then glue them together. We also added some epoxy to the servo, and now it's just a question of putting it in its place, connecting it up with a servo rod. Seems a little difficult. For some help, click. That's it. And of course, make sure the servo is sitting centered. Up. You can finally seek for the final position. Make sure that the wheels are straight, 90 degrees. Make sure the servo is in the correct position. Everything is set even. And it's always smart to put a clamp on it and make sure that everything is sitting in the correct position. And then we're gonna just let it dry for a couple of hours. We're gonna be back. The first attempt by using the epoxy, I glued down the servo saver. Now the second time I raised the servo with 2 mm using gift cards, and that gave just enough space between the servo saver and the chassis so it all moves around freely. And at the moment I'm running it on a 5-volt back that just gave us enough power to test it if it stirs correct, but I always recommend to use a 6-volt back to get the maximum torque and speed out of your servos. I can still make some adjustments to get more angle out of it, of course using the FlySky DJ3C radio. But the nice thing about this servo is that it is a full metal servo, and I got a pretty nice amount of torque to steer these wheels, but on 6-volt it just works a little bit better. And I also want to get the maximum performance with an off-road buggy like this Fire Eagle Wheel Toys 12-48. I really hope you enjoyed this episode, and give it a thumbs up because that really helped me. That really helps this video. And of course, if you're new, then I hope you subscribe, and I hope to see you next time. We're going to install the 60 amp waterproof Raystar EEC to make the car run and test how all the new upgrades work. I hope to see you then. Goodbye, and thank you all for watching.